This data analysis AI will definitely change the way you analyze the data. It can even generate complex SQL queries for you. Be sure to watch this video until the end to discover the name of this data analysis AI and learn how to set it up. Now let me demonstrate what you can achieve with this AI tool for data analysis. Just like any other data analysis tool, this data analysis AI also needs to connect with your database. Let me demonstrate. Click on New Chat and then New Connection. It appears that for the time being, we can only connect with PostgreSQL, MySQL, SQL Server, MongoDB and Snowflake database. Let's choose PostgreSQL. Next, you have to construct a connection string in the same manner as shown here. Let's do that. When creating this string, be careful with the parameters. In my case, the username and passwords are Postgres. The hostname is localhost and I have configured it on port number 5432. Additionally, I am using the database named training_db_v2, which I have created. In your case, all these parameters could be different. I have created a video series demonstrating how to set up PostgreSQL and create a database in it. If you are interested, you can watch that. Check the pinned comment for the link. Click connect and you will be presented with a ChatGPT-like interface where instead of writing complex SQL queries, you can chat with the database in natural human language. Let me demonstrate. I am certain that by now you must have noticed from the interface of this data analysis AI that we can interact with our database and request it to generate basic or even complex SQL queries for us. Just like we do with the ChatGPT. Let's begin with the simple queries and then I'll push its limit to see how proficiently it can craft complex SQL queries. Let's begin with basic SQL queries. For the demonstration, I will be utilizing the tables employees, departments and salaries, which are created in the database named training_db_v2, a demo database I have set up in PostgreSQL. The best part of this data analysis AI is that it features GPT-4. Let me quickly switch from GPT-3.5 to GPT-4. First, let's quickly examine the structure of these tables. That was quick. As we can observe, the tables employees and salaries have 3 columns each, whereas departments has 2 columns. Let's ask this data analysis AI to generate some SQL code. I'm going to ask it to retrieve the names of employees along with their corresponding department names and salaries. This query requires the use of SQL joins. Let's see how well it can handle it. Remarkably, this AI tool is quite swift. It displays the query along with the result. Let's ask it to explain what type of joins it used in the above query and see if it is not only proficient at coding but also helpful for learning. That's nice. It explained all types of joins used in the above query very nicely. Now it's time to challenge this AI for data analysis with some complex SQL queries. I'm going to ask it the following. Retrieve the names of all employees along with their corresponding department names. For employees who have multiple salary records, show the highest salary amount they have received. Include all employees, even those with null values in the department or salary tables. If an employee has a null department, display no department assigned. If an employee has no salary records, display no salary record. Sort the result by department names in ascending order, and then by employee names in ascending order within each department. This is indeed a complex query. Its solution necessitated the use of functions like callback, SQL joins, and subqueries. Let's see if this data analysis AI can solve it. It's taking some time. I believe we have stumped it. It seems to be encountering some difficulties. The good news is that it's attempting to solve the problem on its own. Now the question is, will it be able to display the output of our query? After struggling for quite some time, it finally produced the output. Once again, remarkably swift, it displayed the query and the output. So far, we have seen how well this data analysis AI works with SQL. Now let's see if it can actually perform some business analysis. Can it assist us in visualizing our data and creating some charts? Let's find out. Once again, I'm using this data analysis AI. Next, I'll ask, using the employees and departments table, can you create a visualization that displays the distribution of employees across all departments within our organization? Ensure that the visualization includes all department names along with the x-axis and the corresponding number of employees along with the y-axis. Let's see if it can fulfill this request. It's querying the database. It may take a moment. It gives us the bar chart exactly as we asked. Amazing. Let's try another query. Using the employees and departments table, can you create a visualization that demonstrates the average salary for each department within our organization? Ensure that the visualization includes all department names along the x-axis and the corresponding average salaries amount along the y-axis. Let's see if it can show us the distribution of average salary this time. Once again, we got the chart as required. This chart consists of the average salary of only three departments. What about the remaining two? Let's ask it. You only showed average salary across only three departments. What about rest two? It seems salary information is not available for the rest of the departments. I'm impressed. However, one thing I noticed is that it would be better if we could download these charts for further use. Unfortunately, it seems there is no way to do that. If you find a way, let me know in the comments. This data analysis AI is relatively new and it seems like the team is continuously working on it, introducing new features. I have learned that you can even integrate this data analysis AI into any web app. However, this feature is still in the beta stage. I'm eagerly anticipating using it. It's time to unveil the name of this AI for data analysis, and it is AskYourDatabase. Setting it up is incredibly simple. Just visit its website and download it. If you are using ChatGPT 4, you can also grab its extension and start using it. If not, that's not an issue. You can download its desktop app and set it up. The setup process is straightforward. While this data analysis AI is a paid tool, you can try it for free. In the free plan, you will receive 100 database queries per month. I'm excited to see all the plans you have in store for this AI tool. I'm confident you will find it incredibly useful. If you want me to explore more AI options for data analysis, analytics, or SQL, just comment and let me know. That's all for today. Please subscribe for more tutorials on data analysis and SQL. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.